Hey boys and girls, welcome back to Children's Church at Church for Entrepreneurs. I hope you bought your Bible. Let's get ready for today's lesson.
Hey boys and girls, welcome back to Children's Church with Church for Entrepreneurs. Minister April here, and I'm so glad you could join us. As we get ready for today's lesson, let's go ahead and pray. Father God, in Jesus' name, we give you glory, honor, and praise. We thank you right now for your word. Father, your word is everything. It is the very life that we breathe. And as we hide your word in our hearts right now, we pray, Father, that Holy Spirit will have his way, that you will give us wisdom and revelation knowledge of your word, that we may be obedient doers of your word and not forgetful hearers. We give you the praise, glory, and honor for it now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, boys and girls, I'm so excited to have you back this week. We are celebrating Resurrection Day. I am so excited because, as I shared with you on last week, this is the most important day, the most important celebration for us as believers. Why are we celebrating it? I'm so glad you asked, but let's begin. You saw my daughter Priya a little while ago. Hopefully you have your Bible ready. We're going to begin reading at Isaiah chapter 53. We're going to begin at verse 3. We're going to look at two key scriptures today, and as I said, I'm so excited because we're going to learn and understand a little bit more about the resurrection of our Lord Jesus and why this week, today, is such a special day to celebrate. Beginning at Isaiah chapter 53, verse 3, it says, "He was despised and rejected of men, a man of griefs and sorrows, and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we were healed." We are healed. So boys and girls, what we're learning about is the Old Testament prophesied about what would happen to Jesus and what he would undergo. And so, boys and girls, I want you to remember two key objects this week. The first thing I want you to remember is the stick. The second thing I want you to remember, boys and girls, is the stone. So once again, we're remembering the stick and the stone. And so, boys and girls, this verse in verses 4 and 5, it talks about the suffering that Jesus went through in his physical body. It says that he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. That means that all of the pain, all of the hurt, all of the sorrow, all of the sickness that we would go through for our entire life and for the entire world, it was placed upon the back and shoulders of Jesus. And it said, "We did esteem him stricken and smitten of God and afflicted." That means that even though Jesus was going through all of that, a lot of people, when he walked the earth, they didn't esteem him. They didn't recognize and honor him for who he was and what God was doing in his life. They looked at him as somebody that was causing trouble, somebody that was causing change that they didn't welcome in Rome at that time, or in the world at that time. And they looked at him as if he was somebody that God had cursed. In verse 5, this is the key verse. It says, "But he was wounded for our iniquities and bruised for," he was wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities. That means that when they put Jesus on that cross, that's where we get the stick from. When they put Jesus on that cross, now it wasn't a small stick like that. They actually cut down part of a tree, and they cut it down until a point where it was manageable for him to carry. It was a huge burden for him to carry that cross. It was rough. It wasn't smooth, as you may see in some movies. You've got to consider that they went, when they crucified people on the cross, they weren't trying to make it comfortable. They tried to make it a awful and a humiliating death. So I can only imagine the splinters and the scrapes and the scratches that he got. Now, if somebody has ever hit you with the branch or a stick from a tree, it hurts. So imagine somebody putting a tree trunk, the weight of a tree trunk on your back and telling you to carry it, or putting it across your shoulders and telling you to carry it. Jesus went through all of that pain, not only the pain of carrying the cross, but they whipped him, they beat him, they spit on him, they bruised him, they punched him, they kicked him. The Bible tells us, boys and girls, that you couldn't even recognize Jesus because of all the bruises and the blood that was on him. He went through an awful time before he even made it to that cross, before they even nailed him to that cross. But you know why he did it? The Bible tells us that he did it. He did it for us. He said he was wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. So for every time that they whipped his body with that whip, Jesus did it for our healing. In other words, he knew that if he went through that suffering on our behalf, then that would mean that the healing power of God would forever be available for every person throughout all eternity. So you know what, boys and girls? He recognized that that short period of time that his physical body was being bruised, it was paying a price for us that would go on throughout all eternity. So every stripe, every bruise, every way that his physical body suffered, he looked at you and me some 2,000 years later. He looked at everybody that was in the earth and said, or ever that would ever be born into the earth, he said, I love you so much that even though you don't know me, even though you don't even understand all that I did, I'm willing to do it because you're worth it to Father God. Now, boys and girls, let's quickly turn to Luke chapter 24, because our time is coming to a close. So as you know, boys and girls, Jesus, before they put him on the cross, they paraded him through the streets and they bruised him, they beat him, they spit on him, they embarrassed him, they ripped his clothes off of him, they put a crown of thorns on his head. And the reason why they put that crown of thorns on his head is a king or somebody in royalty wears a crown. That's what represents their, one of the things that represents their royalty. But Jesus, they put thorns on his head. In other words, they say, yeah, he thinks he's a king. Well, let's see what kind of king he is. We're going to put a terrible crown on him. And when they put that crown on him, it crushed into his skin and he bled even more. But boys and girls, even though his physical body went through a lot of pain, and ultimately they got him to the hill where they nailed him to that cross, and his physical body went through pain, and his spirit man cried out, because before he gave up his life on that cross, he physically went through, he spiritually went through separation between him and God. And he cried out, he said, Father, Father, why have you forsaken me? Because at that period of time, God had to turn his back on him. And at that moment, when Jesus breathed his last breath, he went down into the pit of hell, and he was there for 3 days and three nights, and he suffered everything that Satan and every enemy and every demon on the face of the earth could ever put upon him. But you know what, boys and girls, he went through that. The devil thought he had him, but he didn't. The devil thought he had Jesus in the place of victory. He thought he had won the victory over Jesus. But boys and girls, I need you to understand that after Jesus had paid the price, after God looked at him and said, it is enough, it is finished, you have done the work I've called you to do, you have paid the price for the sins of everybody on this earth, he said, now you can take your life up again. And what Jesus did, boys and girls, the Bible tells us that he spoiled principalities and powers and made a show of them openly. That means that Satan got the biggest butt kicking he ever could imagine when Jesus rose from the dead. Jesus rose from the dead, he threw off those demons, he threw off every evil spirit, everything that Satan could ever throw at him, every sickness, every disease, every curse, every plague, Jesus threw it off of him, and he rose back to life in victory. And so, boys and girls, you need to understand that the reason why we celebrate Resurrection Day, it has nothing to do with an Easter bunny. It has nothing to do with eggs. It has nothing to do with the new clothes or just going to a fancy restaurant for dinner. It has everything to do with the fact that this weekend, this day, Resurrection Day, represents the defeat, the eternal defeat of Satan. Now, Satan still will come at you. The Bible tells us that the thief comes not but for to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, but I am come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. So, boys and girls, when we look at what Jesus did for us on that cross, when we look at what he did when he was placed in, when his body was put in the tomb, but he was placed in hell, you need to realize this is a representation of our victory. Because boys and girls, they took his body off that cross and they put it in a tomb. But guess what? It didn't stay there. And so the Bible tells us in Luke chapter 24, I misplaced my page. I'm going to turn there again. I am so excited. My goodness. Luke chapter 24, this is the important verse. We're talking about Mary Magdalene, and there was another Mary, and it says, Now upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulchre or the tomb, bringing spices with which they had prepared, and certain others with them. Luke chapter 24, verse 1. We're looking at verse 2 now. It says, and they found the stone. They found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre, and they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed or confused thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. Those two men, boys and girls, were angels. And as they were afraid and bowed their heads, as the two ladies were afraid and bowed their heads to the earth, they said unto them, the angel said unto them, why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Boys and girls, I need you to understand that the angels proclaimed to Mary Magdalene and the other Mary. They said, listen, you came here looking for somebody that's dead. They said, why are you looking for the living among the dead? He's not here, but he's risen. Boys and girls, that's why we celebrate. We celebrate because death couldn't hold Jesus down. Sickness couldn't hold him down. No power of the enemy could hold him down. But boys and girls, his physical body was put in that tomb, but his spiritual body rose to new life. Those angels rolled that stone away. And boys and girls, if you go to that tomb, you will never find the bones of Jesus. You'll never find his physical body or a trace of it. Why? He is not there. Where is he, boys and girls? He is alive. That's the excitement that we have as believers. We serve a risen Savior. We serve a Savior that is alive. He's right now living. Not only is he living in our heart, but he's alive and he's sitting at the right hand of Father God. Boys and girls, I'm so excited, but our time has run out. I hope you were blessed by today. I hope you've enjoyed your Resurrection Sunday, or you will enjoy your Resurrection Sunday. Remember, boys and girls, the reason why we celebrate is not the fact that he died on the cross, not simply the fact that he died on the cross, not simply the fact that he was placed in that tomb. We celebrate because he is alive. He is risen. Satan and death and all of the demons in hell could not keep him down. And so, boys and girls, that means that the power that raised Jesus from the dead, that same power is alive on the inside of us. So just like the angels told those disciples, they said, go tell the disciples, he's not here. He's no longer dead. He's alive. That's what I want you to do. I want you to go and I want you to tell your friends and tell your family and tell everybody that you know, he's not here. He is risen. I love you, boys and girls. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day.